first, I'm going to start by taking out my little raggedy bun. I've had this bun in for a couple days. And as you can see, my curls are not really as defined as I would like them to be. They look more really, really stretched out. And as you can see around my hairline, it looks a little frizzy. And the curls are not really defined. So what you're going to need first is a spray bottle. You can put a little bit of whatever leave-in conditioner you use. The kind of products that I'm going to be using in this video is, first, one of my favorites is a curling gel souffle. It's by Shea Moisture. And secondly, I use the curl enhancing smoothie, also, as you can see, by Shea Moisture. And then you want to get whatever leave-in conditioner you use. I use the Jamaican Black Castor Oil. And one of my faves, the Curl and Style Milk, also by Shea Moisture. And you want to get a brush. This is the kind of brush I use. As you can see, it has bristles that are like really, really hard. And these kind of brushes help define your curls when you brush your hair. I have two. So another one I have is just a little bit bigger. Same kind of brush though. Really, really hard bristles. And yeah. So first you want to start by just spraying your hair. Spray, spray, spray. You want to get the water all over your hair. You don't want to spray too much to where your hair is like dripping. You want to spray just enough. Damn, I'm surprised that you called, 'cause the way you walk, the way I thought. And then what you want to do is you want to just split your hair right down the middle, and you want to just tie half of your hair up with a little scrunchie or hair tie, whatever you want to call it. So yeah, so I'm just tying half my hair up right now, trying to get it out the way. I'm just gonna spray my hair with a little bit more water on this side. Just, I want to get a little more wet, so when I do put the product in, the product kind of holds better. First, I'm going to start off with the leave-in conditioner that I'm going to be using, which is the Strength and Grow Leave-In Conditioner by Shea Moisture. And I just want to get like a quarter size. I don't want to get a lot because I don't want to weigh down my hair. I still want volume in my hair. So I'm just going to put it all throughout my hair, make sure I'm getting it all in there. And I'm just going to split my hair halfway, so I can just focus on a little bit at a time. So now that I got that out the way, I'm gonna get the spray bottle and spray a little bit more water in my hair. And I'm gonna get a little bit more of that leave-in conditioner and put it throughout this small portion of my hair. Make sure I get it all in there, get it throughout my hair. So as you can see, my hair looks way more shiny and it doesn't look as dry and brittle as it did before. So I'm just gonna add a little bit more of that Shea Moisture Jamaican Black Castor Oil Conditioner. And next, I'm gonna get some of this Curl Gel Souffle, also by Shea Moisture, and I'm gonna put first just a quarter size, just like I did when I did the leave-in conditioner, just a little, because again, you do not want all these products to weigh down your hair. And as you can see, the way that I'm applying this in my hair is I'm taking my hands, I rub them together to get the product throughout my entire hand, and I'm gliding my hand down my hair. The reason why I do this is because if I just put it straight throughout my hair and put my fingers through my hair and comb, like kind of comb it through my hair, it's splitting my curls apart. And when you're using a gel, you don't want it to do that. So the next product that I'm using is the Curl Enhancing Smoothie. Sorry, a piece of hair got stuck on my finger, as you can see my face expression. But I'm getting the same amount of size, just a little bit, because I don't want it to weigh down my hair. And I'm doing the same thing. I'm rubbing it throughout my hands and I'm gliding it across my hair. Gliding it across my hair. Because I don't want to break apart my curls. And I'm going to do the exact same thing to the top part of my head. So I'm going to kind of, well, the top half part of my hair. And I'm going to kind of speed this up. So, yeah.
I'm surprised that you called, cause the way you walked away, I thought I wasn't gonna see you no more. Since you didn't wanna give me your man, I thought that you were digging me and wasn't digging me. But anyway, what you doing tonight? I'll probably be quitting my peeps. If it's cool with you, maybe we'll swing by and you can just chill.
Okay, so now that I'm done doing all that, as you can see, my hair looks more shinier. It doesn't look all dry and nasty looking. But so what I like to do to around my hairline area is I like to make them look even more defined. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna just take a little small piece and we're gonna spray it with some water. Again, don't drench it, just spray a little bit of it. And we're gonna take the little bristle brush and we're gonna just brush the front of our hair. To me, this helps my hairline look a little more better. It doesn't make it look as dry and it helps the curls in the front of my hair look way more defined. Maybe we can go see movie girl. Maybe we can. So now I'm just gonna kind of scrunch those and just mess around with my hairline a little bit, just the hairs in the front, and that's about it. So now I'm gonna go ahead and do the other side of my hair. You hopefully get the point of what I'm doing and the steps that I'm doing it. As you can see, this side looks way more dry. Here's a picture that I have that kind of shows the difference. I don't know if the camera can capture that. So basically what I'm gonna do is do the exact same steps to the other half of my hair. So I'll come back and show you what it looks like afterwards. So now that I've done the other side of my hair, basically as you can see, my hair looks way more defined. Well, my curls look way more defined and they look more shinier, they're way more bouncier. So I like to refresh my curls the night before I go to school. And how I keep my curls from not getting frizzy at night is I tie all my hair up into what most girls call a pineapple. I use a little scrunchie and I pull all my hair to the top of my head and I just tie it up. Usually I would put a satin bonnet on, but I don't have one right now because I lost it. So I'm just gonna sleep like this and it's gonna keep all my curls locked in and they won't get frizzy like this. So that's about it and thank you so much for watching. Bye!